First, let me start off by saying that I will not be using any of the music by the artist formerly known as, or currently known as, Prince. That's my message to Prince. He's like Symbol, so I'm giving him a symbol. Yes. For those of you who have not seen, or have seen, or don't care, or do care, last week's video, my Wednesday last week's video, was muted, was silenced, was censored by the evil corporation of YouTube / Universal / Prince. I'm not going to re-edit the video. I'm leaving it as a monument to censorship. Anyway, I have enjoyed this week's videos. Michael's venture into Five Awesome Gayish Land. He looks so cute in his little tank top and his glasses and all dancing around, you know. I would never do something cheap like that in my videos. I like to keep things serious and dignified, as you can tell by my ensemble. I was trying to be all Five Awesome Gayish. But he challenged Van to come up with a challenge for the week, and she came up with something about tea and children. And it reminded me of a story. Because, you know, as once get, you know, once does get older and one does think about adopting and having children, perhaps, you know, one is getting adopts, or, you know, if you find people willing to, you know, help a nigga out, you know what I'm saying? You know, they can artificially inseminate somebody or blah blah blah. I have given adoption a thought, and when I was younger in my 20s, I thought, well, when I hit 30, I'm probably gonna end up adopting a child or blah, 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 and then I hit 30 and realized I am in no shape to be adopting a child. So now I'm considering pushing it to 40, but, you know, Van's challenge did make me think of a story of when I actually went to an adoption agency just to kind of, you know, feel things out and see what my options were in that department. And I get to the adoption agency and I met up with a very nice woman and we talked for a while until she informed me that they only offered flavored children at the agency. I just wanted a regular child, you know, unsweetened. They only had flavored children. And I asked her, why do you only offer flavored children? She didn't have an answer for it. Then I'm even wondering, well, what is a flavored child? Are we going to go down the ethnic route? I mean, are black children and Hispanic children flavored? What if I want a Caucasian child? Does that mean that automatically that the child has no flavor? So if I adopt a flavored child, or a non-flavored child, then I have to be all, like, worried about their flavor and stuff? And what if I adopt a Caucasian child and the poor thing has no flavor? What if he gets called a cracker? Then I have to come up with something, you know, like, well, you know, you may be a cracker, but you're a saltine because you might be white, but you still got flavor. Sorry for that bad joke. Truth is, I really shouldn't be allowed around children, and I don't really like tea that much. Although I do like green tea, and I do like that sweet tea that they sell at McDonald's. Although it's a little too sweet, but it's $1 for a really big cup. That's pretty much all I have to say on that. if the other four oldies would like to contribute topics, feel free. I will meet any challenge you have. And we're coming up on our 100th video soon. I don't know who the 100th video falls on, but whoever it is, we should do a little collab. You know what I'm saying? All five of us in one video. That's what I'm saying. That's all I'm saying.